Hello, everyone. Welcome to Playtime is Over Radio. I'm your host, Cheryl Wood. I'm so excited to have you here today. We have a great topic today, a celebration of curves. And I have an amazing woman in the studio with me, Donna Hunley. Girl, I don't want to call you Donna. I just want to say Curvy Chicks Chariot. Hey. That's all I want to say.
You can
Curvy
call Chicks me that.
CCC. Hey, CCC. That's really what. Say hello to the folks.
Hello, everyone. How are you?
From the this Derby Diva. Lady is amazing. She is doing such phenomenal things. And I remember when we first met, I don't even remember when it was, but it was at a Meet the Media event I signed up for. I had never been there before. And I didn't meet a whole lot of people while I was there, but it just so happened that you and I, we actually connected.
That's right.
And I remember then you telling me about this thing that you were going to be embarking upon, but it wasn't fully up and running yet. And now look at your girl. We'll talk about that. You are doing the thing.
Thank you.
So we'll talk about that. And first, I want to give a shout out to our sponsor, What Box Media, Miss Vanessa Monago. Shout out to you. Thank you so much for sponsoring this show so that we can be here live on the air every Tuesday from 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. Eastern Time. We do air in over 135 countries, and we are just excited to bring to you a positive show, an exciting, a fun show every week with men and women who are doing just that. They're living outside of the box. They're expanding their expectations for their lives, and they're not allowing excuses or procrastination or any of those things to keep them stuck in their current reality. Right. They're saying, you know what? I got some big dreams and I'm going for it. Mm-hmm. Right. Because why not?
That's right.
That's what I always say to my clients. Why
you
not?
Do it.
Why not now? Why not you?
That's right.
If not you, it's going to be somebody. So you might as well jump in. Oh my goodness. I just realized, Eric, I forgot to put lipstick on. Can you believe that? I'm going to be going through the whole show talking about I forgot. I left my red lipstick in the bag. Darn it. See, that's what happens. That's the real life of an entrepreneur, right? I got my kids in the back. I had to go get them chicken nuggets before we came into the studio. Then I'm threatening them. I'm like, you better not say anything. You better be quiet during the show. Like, that's the real life of an entrepreneur. And then I forgot my lipstick. All that fussing and carrying on, I forgot my red lipstick. It's okay. We'll get through the show anyway. I want to give another shout out as well to Donnie Glover of Be More News. You can check him out on the web at bemorenews.com, as well as Micheline Bowman from Fox 5 News and Peggy Morris from Sisters for Sisters Network Incorporated. Yesterday they had their, I guess it's a monthly event that they have. It's a networking event where they honor people, especially African-American entrepreneurs who are doing positive things in the community. Come on in, lady. We're waiting for another guest, and she just got here. I know traffic is crazy. Parking is crazy. Girl, we're happy to have you here.
You have your quarters.
I'll introduce her in a moment. But last night, I was honored with this award. I brought it with me. I actually stuck this in my purse. I remembered that, but forgot the red lipstick. Okay, so this is the Joe Mann's Black Wall Street Award, presented to Cheryl Wood. And this is for my work as an entrepreneur and empowering women as far as personal empowerment as well as economic empowerment. And so I was so excited to be there. Thank you. Bing, bing. Let's ring
great.
The bell.
I know. That deserves it. Absolutely. Congratulations.
And it's always, I mean, I love what I do anyway. So it's always an honor to be recognized for your work. Like, nobody has to stop and say thank you. No one has to stop and say you're doing an amazing job. You just do it because you love it.
That's right.
And I was so honored to be to receive the award alongside so many amazing men and women. Raheem Devon was there last night. He was honored. He's right out of the DMV. And you know who else was there? Guess who else was there? Eric? Queen Aisha. She was honored yesterday. Yeah. Queen Aisha has a show that comes on directly after this show. And she's a comedian, African-American comedian, who's just blowing up the charts.
Yeah.
She was honored. Sonia Lowry, my girl. You got to check her out online and on Facebook. She's doing amazing things. She's always doing that crazy jumping out of plane stuff, adventure stuff.
Ooh, that's okay.
I think her show is called Sonia's World Next Door or something like that. I just know her name, Sonia Lowry. That's my girl. She has great energy. She's always doing adventures throughout the DMV. Mm. So if you're looking for something fun to get into, something exciting, you want to connect with her. She was there and she was honored. Barbara Holt Streeter, who is known as Mrs. PR Protocol, who has done a lot of my PR work in the past, especially for my big event that I did last August, the Sizzle event. She did all of my PR. So she got me on Fox 5 News. I was on News Channel 8, Let's Talk Live. I was on WHUR. I mean, the list just went on and on. Wow. So she's doing amazing work. So just to be side by side with all of these wonderful men and women who are pouring back into the community and who are actually sharing their gifts with the world is always an honor to be recognized. So again, thank you, Donnie Glover of Be More News, and Peggy Morris and Micheline Bowman. I really appreciate you guys for recognizing me and recognizing my work. Thank you so much. All right. So we are ready to get into this topic today. It is a topic that I'm passionate about. I never thought I would be this curvy, but it's okay. It happens, right?
I'm here with you.
It happens. You know. And I think what I love about what you do, Donna and Nisha, we're going to bring you right into the conversation. First of all, am I saying your name right, Nisha?
Absolutely.
Okay, good. No, Every time I say it, I'm like, I hope I'm saying her name right. I am so horrible with names. I never forget a face. Yes. Never forget a face. I'll be like, I know that person. Give me a minute. Right. I'm going to tell you. But girl, I will jack your name up.
No, so many just people just say, they answer. They're used to people messing it up.
For me, I don't care if you mess up my name when you're talking to me, like if you're saying it. But when you mess up my name in print,
that's right.
That irritates me a little bit. Because I'm like, I'm not Woods. There's no S on the end of my name. I'm Wood. Yeah. Like, at least take the time to research who I am.
We need to fix that on the website, please.
You know what I mean? Oh, sorry. In print, it's a little bit different. I don't get irate about it, but it's like, dang, it would have been nice to have my name spelled correctly. But anyway, that's a whole other topic.
They leave Cherry off my name all the time.
Do they?
They tag me Curvy Chicks. I'm like, that's a different business.
Right.
Please make sure you put the whole name. Curvy Chicks, Cherry. It has to be together. Absolutely.
And it's so funny because I didn't even know your name was Donna. I know your name. All I knew was Curvy Chicks Cherry.
She said, don't be mad. I don't know your name.
Girl, what's your name? What's your first name?
That's fine. As long as you know Curvy Chicks Cherry.
Right. That's all that matters. Yes, exactly. Yes. So the conversation for today is a celebration of curves. And I invited Nisha in because she has this amazing company called Synergy. And all of the work that she does really is around celebrating us as women, who we are as we are.
Absolutely.
So I know you'll add great content to this conversation. And of course, my girl, Donna, I know your name now, from Curvy Chicks Chariot. Let's see how many times you can say that in like 30 seconds. I'm calling a CCC. Hey, CCC.
That's fine.
And so let's jump into the conversation. So I am now considered a plus size woman. Oh, and I'm not even gonna lie, it still makes me cringe.
I'm not gonna lie, it makes me cringe.
Does it?
I gained 70 pounds in a year. Imagine gaining 70 pounds in a year.
I had to
take in the fact that, okay, yes, I'm a pretty in the face, thick in the waist. Thank you.
Jeez, I love that.
Absolutely.
It took me, and it's still taking me, you know, I'm like, I don't know why I don't like that term, plus size woman. I don't know if darn plus, I'm just fluffy. I'm a little fluffy. And I don't know if that's because of, I just want to make it sound better. You know, I do want to work on it. But at the same time, I think it's important while you're working on it to celebrate where you are and the space that you're in. And I don't want to walk around with my head hanging down because I'm not the size that I want to be.
Absolutely.
And so I think what you're doing, and we'll talk all about your business, is wonderful.
Thank
so why
you.
Don't you introduce yourself officially and tell us all about this business that I keep going on. And everybody's like, what is it? What is it?
Well, Curvy Chicks Chariot, it is a fashion truck. And a lot of people have no idea what a fashion truck is.
And we have some photos. We can pull those up. I think it's under Curvy Chicks. We have a few pics so people can get a visual of exact. Okay, so look at that.
Oh, wow.
That's the inside of our truck.
Look at her.
Okay.
Yeah,
I was
fierce.
There it is. There's a truck.
Thank you.
There's a truck. Fashion on the plus size fashion on the move. Yes. That's gorgeous. I love that picture.
Thank you.
We just bust all into your little introduction.
No, it's okay. I'm excited.
Look, and that's horrible. I'm like, it's okay. We can look at me.
But I love it. Okay, so now you can explain to them.
So you see the inside of my truck, right? And so it was an old vending truck. It was FedEx truck before. And then it turned into a vending truck, and I gutted it out and turned it into a boutique. The reason why, and I opened up the boutique on wheels so that it could be different.
Yes.
I want to compete against some of the traditional size boutiques, as well as those stand out as a plus size boutique that's different than what you're normally seeing. So I end up having, you know, different designers, wholesalers, high-end, low-end clothing. And so I make it affordable. I try and keep my items really fresh. And I really encourage women to embrace their curves, because mm-hmm. a lot of us are so hard on ourselves, yeah. you know? And oftentimes when people come into my shop, they come in defeated before they've tried anything on.
That's so powerful.
Yeah, they come in. I say, can I help you? And they say, oh, nothing's going to fit me. I said, this whole truck fits you. How about that? And if you really feel bad, I'll put something on you that's too big so you can say, oh, this is too big. Then you'll feel really good. That's right. But I wasn't always plus size. And initially, I mean, mine was due to an illness that I ended up gaining a whole bunch of weight. Okay. And it was hard. You know, I was like, I was embarrassed to see people because mm-hmm. they hadn't seen me in a little
yes.
while. And one person came up to me and said, do you have a sister named Donna? I was like, I am Donna. Right. You know? wow. But after, you know, getting over that, I realized, just because I'm plus size doesn't mean I'm not beautiful. Yes. I still like I still like to hold myself with, you know, the best, most pride as possible, keep my, you know, clothing looking very nice and, mm-hmm. you know, show people that I don't have to have stuff hanging off and look sloppy. I can look just as good as a traditional size woman. Mm-hmm. So I opened up my truck and I try and spread the same message. This is a movement to me.
Yeah.
It is not just a clothing store. Mm-hmm. And hopefully my message can continue to move throughout the coast so that we can, you know, embrace our curves using my business as a vehicle. Yes.
That is what, literally, as a vehicle,
I was
right?
About to say that. Literally.
That is good stuff. Yeah,
thank
and you look absolutely amazing
sure.
today.
Thank
girl,
you.
I'm looking at your eyebrows like, dang, that's the other thing I ain't get done with my
girl.
Look, my kids are home all summer. I have them all day.
Yes.
Every day during the summer.
I'm
and let me tell
too.
You, it is nothing but
that.
The truth. Entrepreneurship don't have nothing on motherhood.
Mm-hmm.
It is a 24/7 job. Mm-hmm. And it's like your needs get kind of pushed into the background.
Yeah.
But what I love about what you're doing is that you're right. For me, that my experience as a fluffy woman has been, I hate going shopping because
mm-hmm.
all the stuff is ugly.
Right.
It's oversized. It's black or it's gray. There's
yes.
no colors. And I'm like, that's not me.
Nope.
And so that drives me crazy. So anytime I have to go and look for an outfit for an event where I'm going to speak, it is like murder. And
mm-hmm.
I'm like, are you kidding me? They can't make anything else. So you are like stepping in and filling that void.
Absolutely.
I believe in the plus size market.
Absolutely.
That we need so
yeah,
much.
I try. And you know, the other thing is I do private shopping because what I've found is we don't necessarily want, we feel more comfortable when we have less people around
mm-hmm.
trying. You don't
mm-hmm.
want to step out the dressing room for fear that it might be too tight.
Judge
or
me.
It might, yeah. So I'll do private shopping where I'll bring my truck to people's homes or their
wow,
business.
Wow, I didn't know that.
I'll park right out in front.
Wow.
And for an hour and a half, there's a minimum spend. But for an hour and a half, you have the whole store just
wow.
to yourself.
Wow.
Like,
that is
time.
Hot.
Yeah.
Oh my God,
yeah.
girl, I didn't
yeah.
even know that.
Absolutely. So what I was saying about the styling, I mean, people have events that they want to go to and they want to be able to not be rushed.
Mm-hmm.
Not, I have one dressing room, so they don't want to compete for
yes.
the dressing room,
yes.
even though I'll say, let's shut the door, you can just dress right here, you know?
Right.
But I just try and do that so that people have the opportunity to shop privately.
Wow, talk about creativity and innovation.
Mm,
okay, but
you.
let's ask this question though. Is
okay.
it affordable for the everyday woman?
Mm.
Or do you have to be a senior level executive at a big corporation to be able to afford to have you come park in front of somebody's house?
No, let me tell you, $250 is my minimum spend.
Wow.
That's not hard.
That
is,
no.
You and
at
if you,
all.
$250, you can walk away with about four or five outfits, depending on how we play with it.
Wow.
Most of the times, my outfits are transitional. So I will make sure that when you leave, if it's possible to wear that skirt as a dress, you will learn how to do that.
That is wonderful.
If it's possible to wear this shirt with sleeves as a strapless, because we just play around and do some twists, you will learn before you leave. I take my time with you and
wow.
I make sure that the $250 minimum spend is something that people, when you're going to a special event, especially,
yeah.
you $250
yeah.
is really nothing
no.
when you're thinking
no.
about that. But,
no.
you know, you can have private parties. $250 is the minimum spend for private parties and you have to have 10 people present.
Wow.
So that's just $25
that is so
per
person.
That is so, isn't that?
Yeah.
That is spectacular.
Yeah, so
you
very,
are, girl, you're going to blow
affordable.
Up. I just supposed to see it. Just remember my name, girl, when you go up to, you know,
you're gonna be right
the
next
ladder,
to me,
right?
Encouraging everybody to come on.
Well, that's wonderful. I'm so proud to see your progress since when I first met you. You were talking about it, and now it's a reality. Mm-hmm. You know, it's manifesting. And yes. I want to talk a little bit more, though, about the work, because we were talking about that a little bit before mm-hmm. we came on air, the work that really goes into making something like this happen.
Yeah.
Whether it's a truck or whether it's a speaking or whether it's hosting events, whatever it is, it takes a serious grind
right.
and that you have to be committed to for the long haul. It's not just a one and done. Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm going to do it one time and I'm going to blow up and that's it. Right. Most times it does not work.
Absolutely, Cheryl, it is right about that.
Yes, let me push this closer to you.
Absolutely.
And then let's get Miss Nisha Parker on in here. She's mm-hmm. really here to talk about an amazing event, a dynamic event that I got to stop saying that word amazing. I say that word so much.
I say awesome.
I do too. I like amazing and dynamic, right? It makes me feel good in my spirit. I like that. So yes, she is an amazing, another amazing woman who's giving this dynamic event this Sunday, which we're going to talk all about. But first, why don't you tell them who you are, absolutely. What you do, and then we'll flash the photo, the flyer for the event that you're hosting on Sunday.
Okay. So I'm Nisha Parker. I'm the founder of an organization called Synergy. I started this organization about 5 years ago with the premise of, one, individual development, you be good so that we could be good.
Mm-hmm.
The second part of it is to help individuals express all of the their desire to give back mm-hmm. to the communities. And so we have twofold, and it's built on four pillars. One is access to policymakers, access to business people who mm-hmm. have resources that we need to go to the next level.
Mm-hmm.
The second one is advocacy against poverty. I feel very passionate about that. Mindsets to homelessness, to mental health issues, from single momhood, just, you know, not being able to raise your kids at home, they're raising themselves. So we are engaged in the community, and we speak at different places. We actually do teen summits, we do mentoring. So that's the second pillar. The third pillar is professional development. It is very important for us to develop ourselves at every level.
Mm-hmm.
Our mindset, our girlfriends, our money, mm-hmm. you know, all these things. So, and the last one is the media. It is important for us to tell our stories.
Mm-hmm.
It's important for us to learn from one another. Our testimony is not just about us. We mm-hmm. become so that others can.
Mm-hmm.
So Synergy is a collective force, the sum of that thing that's just greater than itself.
Mm-hmm.
So that is what Synergy is. That's what we've been doing. And the event that Cheryl has alluded to earlier.
And there it is. There's the flyer up on the screen.
Cool.
You can see.
Cool.
Yeah, I just saw that.
Nisha, you know I'm so tickled that my face is up there, girl.
Oh, you
thank you for creating that flyer.
You are amazing. It's
that's
bigger
right.
than
absolutely.
I mean, you are amazing.
You don't realize how big you are. You're amazing and motivational.
I mean?
Absolutely.
I think the reality for me is people who know me know it is important for me to have an energy with individuals that's very sincere and genuine.
Yes.
And I am big on getting yourself together so that we can get us together.
Right.
Because
mm-hmm.
if you're not good, then we ain't good.
That's right.
That's the truth.
Mm-hmm.
This event that we're having on Sunday was about next level living. And when I came up with the idea, I was just like, whoa, like, you know, next level is so something that we all talk about, but how does that really look?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I was talking to women who wanted to, they had ideas and they weren't quite sure how to manifest those things.
Mm-hmm.
I was talking to women who just didn't know what the purpose was. They were searching for something. And we all know that if you don't know what purpose you are here for on this earth, that is not fulfilling.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care how much money you have.
Mm-hmm.
The second mm-hmm. were individuals who actually started their businesses, but they needed strategies and they weren't quite sure. They were making mistakes over and over again. And so that is the next group. The other group is individuals who are like maximizing their talents. They're actually doing some incredible things, mm-hmm. such as yourself. But how do we get to the next level? How mm-hmm. do we tap into the Bob Johnson, the Sheila Johnson?
Absolutely.
How do we get the mentors and the access to resources that we need? So
mm-hmm.
I wanted to target all three of us, you know, all three type of women, you know, the idea women, the woman who's doing a little bit, and the woman who's doing a lot.
Mm-hmm.
How do we go to the next level? And so that is what this event is about. Tasha Smith is going to be there. She's
Woo-hoo.
Going to tell her incredible story. And I chose Tasha because she is representative of what I believe Synergy Life is. I mean, she has had a tumultuous, but she's triumphed.
Mm-hmm.
She's very resilient.
Mm-hmm.
She believes in it, and she pushes through. We have to faith it until we make it, and she certainly is a representative of that type of life.
Mm.
So I wanted her to share her story. And the other thing is there, you know, incredible individuals like Cheryl Wood.
Cheryl Wood's there. Cheryl
Wood's in the house. Lucinda Cross from New York is in the
house. Yes, Lucinda.
I think that it is so important for people to have the best, and I consider you all to be the best.
Wow.
And nobody deserves nothing less, not with your own individual self or giving. Give all of you, not a piece of you. Mm-hmm, right. So I wanted to give the best to the individuals who are part of Synergy Life, and that is what this movement is about. So that's very, very excited. Black Enterprise is on board. They're going to be there at the table. Coco Fab is going to be there at the table. TV One will be there at the table. I mean, we have some incredible people. I am just so excited, and I'm excited that you're part of this.
I am so excited as well. I told you, girl, when I got the fly, I was like, that's my face right there. Oh, that's my face. That's my face right there. And I tell people all the time, and I really don't take it for granted, that I've come a long way in a very short period of time. I mean, 5 years for most, that's a short period of time. And I know I still have a lot of work to do and a lot of impact to make in the world. But I am very... I feel blessed that I do know what my purpose is.
Absolutely.
Like you said, there's so many of us who are still so searching and soul searching for, why am I here? What am I meant to do? How do I love myself as I am so that I can get started on the path to what I'm supposed to be doing? And I think also you made some other good points about sharing our voice and telling your story, not trying to compare it to anybody else's story, not saying, her story is better than mine, or, you know, but she dealt with that, and I didn't have that traffic. It doesn't matter. Yes. Somebody is going to relate to and connect to your story, and you sharing your story is going to allow somebody else to believe that their story is important enough to share.
Absolutely.
So, you know, I share a quote, and I shared this quote last night when I accepted this award. I said, you know, Maya Angelou, it's a Maya Angelou quote, and she says, pursue the things that you love doing and do them so well that people can't take their eyes off of you.
Absolutely.
Oh, wow. That's
but it's not in a vain way for them to take their eyes off, not to take, but it's in a way meaning that they don't take their eyes off of you, that you're such an inspiration, that you're such a source of uplifting and empowerment that it moves them to then want to take that and do something with their own lives. And so that's why I'm excited to be a part of this. We met up over at Wegmans. We had our little meetup. You know, Wegmans is the hot spot now. Wegmans over
at Lawrence. They have music too and stuff.
They do.
They got good food. Y'all know, we're going to talk about food. You know what I'm saying? They got good food.
It's a tax write-off for me. Thank you very much.
Exactly. And I did feel an energy and a synergy. And I love that name of your company, Synergy, because I tell clients who I work with all the time, I don't just work with everybody. There has to be a synergy between us. You have to be able to vibe off of my energy, and it has to be a mutual, it has to be like a win-win.
Right.
If we're going to work together, we're going to collaborate, whatever it is, I have to feel something in your spirit that's like, yeah, we got to make this happen. And that's what I love about what you're doing. Yeah. You are definitely bringing in some amazing folks. And this is going to be on a private yacht. Let's talk about that.
How about that?
Let's talk about that. She talked about, I'm pouring it all out. I'm not holding back from y'all. Tell us a little bit about the environment, the setting.
Absolutely. So it's going to be in Annapolis, Maryland, this Sunday coming up. And it's going to be on a private yacht. It's going to be three levels. We're going to have dinner, catered dinner. It's going to be awesome. We have, because I'm so big on youth will be there in tuxedos to deliver all of the food.
Wow. That's awesome.
It's
going
to be plated dinner, and it's going to be some superb. I tasted every ounce myself. I want to give, because it's important. It's love is in the details.
That's true.
Yeah, so I have this special punch. It's called Synergy, and we made it. I'm just so excited about it, and we're going to have a special guest. He's going to be singing. His name is Brian Christopher. Many people may know him. He's been at the many of the local venues around here, Blues Alley, including Blues Alley.
Wow.
So it's going to be great, and we all know that Tasha just gives it.
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait for her to tell her story, because I think as an entrepreneur, it's a grind, like you said, Cheryl. Mm-hmm. It is not easy. We have the visions, and how do you make this happen?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you need the great support of people who believe in you.
Mm-hmm.
You need resources. Mm-hmm. You know, we a lot of us have, you know, we have mortgages, we have car notes, we have clothes with the buy. We have so there we wear many hats, and so I just wanted to provide a next level opportunity for us to see exactly where we need to be to be in the room full of greatness, and to be able to chase that greatness, and that's what I think this is all about.
And that's true. I mean, because when you're in a room with other people who are doing big things, it's a motivator.
Yes.
I mean, I go to some conferences and I go to some events and I walk up in there like, I'm Cheryl Wood, right? And I walk in there, I see what they do. I'm like, Lord, I got to step up my game. And I love being in those environments that motivate me and get me excited to bring my A game. Like, girl, you ain't doing nothing. I love that. Some people allow that to to make them shrink back a little bit. But I don't. I take it as a challenge.
That's right.
And I think that's the experience that we're going to have on Sunday, is that it's going to challenge every person who is there as a part of that event to bring your A game. That's step right. up the pace. Stop playing. Playtime is over. Y'all know that's where we at. Playtime is over. Radio. So then let's kind of go back to the full theme of today and celebrating who we are as we are. So I do know that a lot of women allow themselves to stay stuck and not go to that next level because perhaps they feel like, well, I don't have the look. I don't fit, you know, what success really looks like. And I can tell you some things I've seen and experienced in terms of when you're a certain size versus another size, you know, sometimes you do get more opportunities. And we're in a society where thin is in. So let's talk about that. How do we move beyond the realms of what the media embraces as attractive and as successful and say, well, no, anyone can be successful. It doesn't matter what your outer appearance is. Even, like I said, even if you're working on it, still, how do I get moving now? While I am where I am, how do I love myself enough to say I'm going to jump into my dream as I am and make progress along the way, not wait until I'm here and then start? Both of you can chime in.
I think you touched on something that's very important, and that's surrounding yourself with people who will help uplift you.
Yeah.
You know, when you feel uplifted, or when you know you have somebody you can go talk to, it makes you a little bit more confident about stepping out, you know? And I know that even in gaining my weight, I was like, I'm not sure even in growth of my, you know, I still have a full-time job. So in growth in my full-time job, I was a little hesitant, like, how are they going to receive me now? I worked with clients who were law enforcement, and they're very into physically fit. And I used to make jokes like, well, I guess I can't pass that test, you know. But they do really look at how you look on the outside.
Yes.
And if we exude something that doesn't show anything more than positiveness, from the, you know, we're showing this negative, unsure feeling about ourselves, it's going to be reflected in how you're received. So we have to surround ourselves with the right people who are going to continue to uplift us, and then get to know yourself from the inside and not worry about so much what everybody else is saying. You have to find the right things that make you feel good. Absolutely. If you walk out and you have on an outfit that maybe somebody else is like, what's she having? What does she have on? If you feel good about it, all of a sudden everybody else is going to say, she is wearing that outfit.
Right.
You know?
Right.
It's just all about how you do. But I think that the one thing you need to do is surround yourself with the right people. Don't be around people who are going to bring you down. Somebody who's going to constantly say, how much more weight are you going to gain?
Yes.
Why do you have that on? Only skinny girls wear that. Yes. You know, you don't surround yourself with it. You need to learn how to cut them off. And find somebody else who's going to help lift you up.
Absolutely. Great advice. Great. I hope you're writing that down, folks. Great advice. It's about your community, who you're surrounding yourself.
Absolutely.
That's a great tip.
I totally agree with that. I think you need the right support, because and if you don't, you need to quarantine that and put that in an appropriate place.
Yeah.
But you know, I really honestly think, to add to that, I really think that we really need to go inside and study ourselves, because you actually, you know, whatever you are here is what people feel.
That's right.
Because energy is not lost, it's merely transferred. So I really think that people need to love themselves in their bigness and their smallness and all of that. You have to know that you're great at the core, because you're great. Not because of anything, not because of any exterior thing that you have. I remember there was an interview, or there was a television series, and Maya Angelou was talking to Dave Chappelle. He was going through a very tumultuous time in his life. And she said, I've learned not to pick it up if I don't want to put it down. And then he asked her to explain it. What she meant by that is that you are great because you were born to be great. You're not great because of the way you look, of the way you speak, of the way you dress, of where you live, or any of that stuff. Because when you are high, people will support you. But when you are low, they won't. And you'll be down, and you'll go into an abyss of darkness. So I need you to be good and great just because you are. So externally, it doesn't matter. I mean, if you're going to do anything, do it because it's healthy.
That's right.
You know, I mean, so we all know the truth of judgment. But I need you to be good because you need to be good for you. Because all the energy that you're trying to pour out is going to go somewhere that's not supposed to go. It's not going to be placed rightly if you don't love yourself. So love you and your thick arms and your curviness, all of it, because that is who you are. Your greatness is here.
That's I love that, with your thick arms. That's right.
Go thick thighs. I love that.
That is good stuff. And you know what's so funny? You know, when I met my husband, which was 13 years ago, I was thin. I mean, I was like a size 4. I was teensy. But I mean, I didn't have any kids. Mm-hmm. I lived in the gym, literally. I was there twice a day. Mm-hmm. A lot of people may not know I was a certified personal trainer.
Okay.
I used to train other people.
All right.
I was very, very physically fit. My sister used to call me a beast. Girl, you a beast. I was a beast in the gym. I loved it. And if I had the time now, I'd probably be in the gym twice a day. I just don't have the time. But it's so funny. I still never thought I was good enough. There was still something in my spirit that I was like, oh, I gotta lose 5 more pounds. Or, oh, my arm is jiggling. Now I am much, 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 much more fluffy than I was then. I will not even share the size.
Curvy.
There I'm curvy, go. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel so amazing in my spirit.
That's right.
And sometimes I'll look in the mirror and I'll say, why am I not more unhappy about my size? Like, is that odd to you? Mm-hmm. Like, sometimes I'm looking in the mirror like, maybe I should be more unhappy with the size that I am. But I'm not, because I'm living my dream. I'm making an impact in the world. Yes. We talked about just loving who you are.
Mm-hmm.
I was just having this conversation with my sister the other day. She's going to kill me when she watches these replays. But she was talking about doing something where they can, like, you know, do something with the lines. I was like, why? I was like, I love myself.
Yeah,
I love myself so much just as I am. And I never thought I would get to that place. And I didn't feel anywhere near the way that I feel now when I was a size 4.
Mm.
But now that I'm considered by society as overweight, I love myself so much more. What the heck is that about?
It's loving you. Loving you is the energy that you have inside that you are emitting.
It's the energy.
Yeah.
It is. It's an energy that I have that just, I don't know. I don't know what, even my hair could be sticking up. I love.
But you're not. You're not going to love yourself every day.
And that's
what people have to also realize. Yes. If you don't love yourself this week, it's okay. Mm-hmm. If you don't love yourself tomorrow, that's okay. But you have to recognize what's not making you happy.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And then look to see what will fix it. I mean, I'm not saying that. I mean, since I started my business, it hasn't even been a year yet. Since I started my business, I have gained like 20 pounds. And that's because I have been on my grind and not working out eating what I could quickly get on. And you know how I realized I gained this weight? When I went to the movies and I could not sit properly in that chair. I was like, does this side lift up? You know? But like, when I realized that, though, I turned to my daughter. I said, oh no, we got to do something. I said, I can lose 30 pounds and still be curvy.
Yeah, right, exactly.
So, I mean, but my thing is, I'm not saying that I don't feel like I'm still, you know, a good person and positive about myself, but I recognize that I'm not going to be happy if I continue down this path right now.
Yes.
So I have to fix for me.
Right.
That's not necessarily what would make somebody else happier. So recognize that you're not going to be happy with yourself every day. Mm-hmm. So you don't feel so bad when you do have that bad day.
I mean, I love myself every day, but there are certain parts of me I don't love every day.
Yeah.
There are certain parts I'm like, dang, could the spike come a little bit tighter? Can I get a little freaking suck it in a little bit more? But I also think it's how you, again, the energy from the inside, but also accepting that it's okay to match the outside to what you feel inside.
That's absolutely.
And I think that for me was a big problem for a while. Once I, you know, I became a more curvy woman, I stopped shopping. Because I was like, I'm not buying nothing this size. And I just, no. I went through that phase.
Yeah,
when I didn't want to shop, I didn't want to buy anything. But really, I was doing a disservice to myself because I wasn't putting my best foot forward externally to match my internal.
Mm-hmm.
And even when I started speaking, I tell the story all the time that for a really long time, I wore like the same black suit because I didn't want to shop, but also because I was on a budget and I was spending my money on conferences, not on clothes. But my husband finally pulled me up and said, Cheryl, your perception has to match the energy that you're putting out,
absolutely.
That you're exuding.
Yeah,
and, you know, your success is increasing. And, you know, he went through this whole conversation with me and it was the light bulb finally went off that it's okay to want to make improvements. It's okay to want to lose some weight, release some weight, whatever you want to call it. But in the meantime, you can put your best foot forward.
Absolutely.
And that's what I love about your business is that you're giving curvy women that opportunity to say, I still want to show you, you know, how beautiful I am on the inside, but also I want to display that externally.
That's right. Even if it's that same black suit, if you're really comfortable in that and you feel good standing in front, at least let me give you a necklace to go
with. Yes, exactly. Switch up the necklace, switch up the blouse, do something.
Put on a scarf, something different. But, you know, it's just whatever makes you feel good, but let me help you access
accent yes, that, you yes, know, yes. And that's your life too. Like, yes. Figure out what it is that's going to accentuate what it is you already feel comfortable with yeah. to make you feel even better.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I put up a post to take the conversation on. I put a post on Facebook. This probably had to be, I don't know, a month or 2 months ago or something. I don't even remember, but it's been recently. And because somebody had called me out of the blue, and she had never met me before. She had heard about my work. She had seen me speak on some live stream events and things like that. And she asked me about my weight, which I thought was rude. First of all, you don't call somebody asking them, like, that's not what you call me about. Mm-hmm. And basically saying that what my impression from the conversation was like, oh, well, how can you make the most impact on other women if you don't have your weight under control? Mm-hmm. Girl, wow. When I tell you I had to take 4 or 5 deep breaths before I posted on Facebook my frustration, because I didn't want the frustration to come out the wrong way.
Right.
You know, people know me as a positive, upbuilding person, and I wanted it to still come across that way, but I wanted to say some words and I didn't say. But I was so surprised at the responses that I got when I put it out there. Mm-hmm. And I just basically was like, you know, don't get it twisted. You know, I love myself whether I'm a size 6 or size 16, and where God positions me to make impact in the world, that's what it's going to be.
Absolutely.
And don't ever think that I can't make an impact on women just because I'm not a size 6. Mm. When I say I think I got 600, 700 my likes goodness. On that and hundreds of comments, it is a real issue.
It is.
It is a real issue.
I've been there.
That I've sometimes people, women especially, think that we can't make an impact because of our physical size. Appearance and our size. Wow.
My business, people have sent me the meanest letters.
No way.
They tell me that I'm encouraging obesity, that I'm encouraging unhealthy living.
Wow.
One woman just went on this rant and rave. I mean, it was absolutely appalling. I was in shock.
My goodness.
I just put it out there. Everybody read this post and tell me what you think. And they just went at her. Yes. But she was saying some of the most hateful things, but that was just one. I get them all the time.
Wow.
People are really appalled.
Yes.
Because they feel like when you're a certain size, that means you're unhealthy. Now,
yes.
I haven't been a small woman in years. Last year, before I started this business, I used to run 3 miles a day, but I was still a size 16. Mm. I could outrun any of them,
right.
You know?
Right.
So don't sleep on just because a woman is a plus size woman that
yes.
she's unhealthy.
Yes.
Right now, I'm in an unhealthy period in my life, but I will be healthy again in a minute. And I'm still not unhealthy. I just like French fries.
So. And I'm going to add to her French fries, hot wings. I like hot wings and French fries.
You gotta add a dip.
Some ketchup.
But it's amazing. It's amazing what people think sometimes, and that mentality that keeps them the hostage. Like, I'm not going to put myself out there because mm-hmm. I'm not this size or that size.
It's
but
so true.
Again, it's about going back to our conversation. It's about self-love. It's about the energy that you have and allowing that spirit to exude to other people.
Yes.
And just realizing that, you know what? Life is about growing. Life mm-hmm. is about working on you. So whether it's your physical appearance or whether it's your mindset or whether it's something emotional or your spiritual development, you will always be working on something.
That's right.
It just happens that the physical, the size, is what you can see. Mm-hmm. A lot of us have things we're working on. You just can't see it. We all jacked up and you mm-hmm. just can't see it.
Yes.
And so we've got to right. embrace. And I, that amazes me. But that tells me also as a reminder that no matter how much positivity you're putting out, there's always going to be somebody who
Absolutely.
Has their opinion about what they think it's not.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And you've got to be strong. When I first came into business as an entrepreneur, my husband was like, girl, you better get some thick skin real quick.
Mm-hmm.
Because I had some things that happened and some people did some things, you know, I considered stabbing me in the back and I was all crushed and on, you know, I'm curled mm-hmm. up on the couch crying. He's like, mm-hmm. for real? Really? But you're going to be in business. He's like, He was like, that's what he said. He was like, you better get some thick skin really quick. Because
yeah.
he said, this is what he said to me at the time. You ain't even making no money yet. And you, he said, wait till you start making some real money.
Right.
You really going to see people come out and be against you and naysayers and haters
yeah,
and
absolutely.
Folks who, no matter how positive it is.
That's true.
So you keep doing you, girl. You keep
thank
doing
you.
Your thing because I'm so proud of you.
Oh,
I love
you.
That you're encouraging and empowering women to celebrate their curves,
that's
to
true.
Love who they are as they
thanks
are right
her.
Now. I don't take it at all as you know, encouraging people to be obese. No, we're not. That has nothing to do with
it's
it.
Crazy.
All we're saying is you have that beautiful energy inside. Allow the outside
absolutely.
To match that.
That's right. That's right.
So let's talk a little bit about, and I can't believe we're, you know, the time on this show goes so fast.
Wow.
I'm like, what? Really?
Yeah.
I need 2 hours, WLVS. But let's talk about competition among women. Because, you know, I don't believe we should compete against anybody other than ourselves. But let's talk about when you walk into a room and sometimes people make a judgment on you based just on your outer appearance, what your size is. And sometimes we look at someone else and we're competing internally. We're competing against that person. We haven't even said anything out of our mouths, but we're competing. What is your viewpoint on competition among women, whether it's, you know, based on something that you're achieving in your business or your life, or whether it's based on what you got on or your size? How do we kind of pull that in to be more unified versus competitive and pulling away from each other?
Well, I think that, so you have to remember that people see the world as they see themselves. So it's more about them than it is about you.
Absolutely.
So I think that, you know, we all have a responsibility to do our part for the greater good. And you have to remember that Martin Luther King says, do not look down on a person unless you're lifting them up. And sometimes you are that you're the vehicle by which they see a demonstration of how it's supposed to be. So you have to give them love, even when they don't. And that's very hard for us to do when we don't get the phone calls, we don't get the love, and they don't support us in our events, and they don't come through when they say they are. We're disappointed. But we have to always posture ourselves so that we can be the example. And we have to remember that, because people will fall short all the time. They'll love you today and they won't tomorrow. And you have to remember that people are going through their, you have to take yourself out of yourself and remember they're going through too. You may not know that they are at home and their husband didn't come home last night because he's with his mistress. You may not know that their husband just lost a job, or that they're going through foreclosure, or that their kids are, you know, smoking drugs. I'm just saying that people see things as they are. So we have to keep that in mind so that we can make it a better place. And I think that's how sisterhood should be. We have to always get ourselves outside of ourselves to say, hey, how are you doing? How can I help you? Because I want you better, because you have work to do, because you are great, because you are purposeful. And I need you to, I need to help you to walk through that.
That is such a, man, that's powerful. Get outside of yourself. And I talked about this, I think, on our last show or a couple shows ago, about someone who was offended because I hadn't responded to her in a certain time frame about something that she wanted me to do. And I'm like, you have no idea what I'm doing behind the scenes. I make it look easy, sweetie.
Absolutely.
But it is not.
And your gift makes a way, because you're talented naturally that way.
And it's like, you know, but and I wanted to say, you know, send her a list of the stuff that I had to do just in that week alone. My mom was in the hospital, still is in the hospital. I'm running back and forth to Baltimore to visit her from where I live. I got my kids all summer long. Every 5 seconds, they talking about, we bored. What we going to do today? I got coaching clients. I got speaking engagements I got to prepare for. I'm doing virtual. I mean, people have no idea. And sometimes you just got to remove yourself from your own emotions. You know, don't take everything so offensively so quickly. Give your sister the benefit of the doubt. And I think that we've got to do more of that.
I think we need to ask for help. That's one of the things I think, as entrepreneurs, as women, we are hard to ask. It's hard for us to ask for help. It's hard for us to actually turn to one of our sisters and say, can you help me? And I told my friends, because they've been to my house several times, where I've been sitting in the middle of my room just crying, just like, I can't. And my beautiful interns running around doing stuff, and my friends are running around. They're just doing everything. And they had to tell me, look, I know now you don't know how to ask for help. So I will be offering my help to you going forward. And I feel like, you know, with competition is a healthy thing. It helps keep you on point. And I, you know, women, we always say women dress for men, but we dress for each other. So when we walk in into a room and we are feeling some kind of way about how people are looking at us or how they'll receive us when we come into the room, and that's the competition that you need to take and turn it into a positive thing. Take it and make it so that you feel like, you know, okay, if you feel funny about your size and you're worried, walk in there with your head held a little higher than you would. I tell my daughter all the time, I don't care what's going on. When you walk in that room, you better have your head held high, your stomach held in, and your cheeks held tight, because you're going to go in there with a good smile and keep it going. So I don't look at competition necessarily as a negative thing, but you have to, number one, you know, figure out what is it that you're really competing for, so that you can be the best at that. And if you feel like somebody who may need a little bit of help, needs it, reach out and help them. Yes. I'm very blessed with a lot of really good friends, and I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing without it. But you know what? The reason my girlfriend's mom told me, you're blessed with really good friends because you are a good friend.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And as long as you give, you will receive, you know. So, yeah, absolutely. So I really think that, you know, the competition part will keep you sharp. But be alert. There's somebody who you might connect with in there who is competition, who you still may be able to help just a little bit to help them.
I think that's a good point. I think not putting a negative connotation on the word competition or competitive. I think it's how you view it. I think it's how you approach it. You're right. I mean, you can be among competitors, technically competitors. I'm around other speakers all the time. And when I see them bring their A game, I'm like, oh, I better come with it.
That's right.
Right? Like, I can't come Sunday on my day. No, Lucinda gonna be there. I got to bring my A game. Stop playing. Like, I love that. I love being around other people who are technically competitors.
That's
but
right.
I don't see her as a competition, meaning she's gonna take something from me.
Yeah.
I see her only as adding to me. She adds value to me because she does such an amazing job at bringing her A game that I have no choice but to bring mine.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a great point. And you're right. Just holding our head up high, no matter what, always, but also being willing to say, you know, I need help. I need support.
Mm-hmm.
I think all of those things are important. And that's hard for me. That's hard for me to say, I need some help.
Yeah, it's really hard.
I'm working on that.
It's a hard thing, especially single moms. I'm a single mom, so it's hard. I'm used to doing everything myself.
Mm-hmm.
But I can't, there's no way I could possibly succeed in life, period, and in this business world, doing it all by myself.
Nope.
I'll be rocking in a corner somewhere.
We all need each other. We certainly do.
So there's this quote that I pulled up before I came in, and it kind of speaks to what both of you have talked about, especially you, Nisha. It says, if you're happy, you can give happiness.
Oh, yes.
If you don't love yourself and you're unhappy with yourself, you can't give anything else but that.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And so I think that is a challenge for everyone who's watching this show to really, yes, you want to look amazing. You can connect with the curvy chick's chariot of your plus size woman. She can pull up right to your door, get you all stylish and trendy. You can come out Sunday with Nisha and Tasha Smith and Lucinda Cross and myself and the folks from TV1 and all the other amazing folks who are going to be there, the women of positive like minds, to help you take your thinking and your mindset to the next level. But it all boils down to how you feel internally.
That's right.
You can look beautiful on the outside. You can have your makeup. I mean, you can beat that face.
Yes.
And you can have one of the most beautiful jewelry, accessories, you know, clothing. Red lipstick that I forgot today. Darn. And that's my MAC. That's my good lipstick. You could have all that going on, but it is a matter of once you wipe off or wash off that makeup and you take off those pumps and you put that Coach bag in the corner and you take off the clothes, who are you then?
That's right.
Do you feel amazing in your skin just as you are?
And all of your nakedness.
All your nakedness, girl.
That's right.
Are you fine with that, with who you are? So I want to allow both of you, if you want to talk about anything that you might have coming up, anything that you want to share. I think we have a couple photos that I wanted to flash for Synergy, I believe, Eric. And then we can just kind of have some closing remarks. I think that was that's a book that you had?
I did a book a couple of years ago. People call me at all times of hours asking for a nugget.
Mm-hmm.
And so I said, you know, I'm going to put some of the nuggets in and
Nisha's
I'll make
nuggets.
It really creative.
I love that.
So I did that a couple of years ago.
I love that.
Thank you.
I think we have a couple more that are going to flash up. There was one that I found that's the e-flyer for the event. For those of you who are still interested, are there some tickets still left?
There are a few tickets left.
Okay,
absolutely.
Just a few. So
minus one.
You want to go to synergylife2014.com. Synergylife2014.com. As a matter of fact, when I was at this event getting this award last night, a lady was like, girl, I'm coming on Sunday. I'm like, get your ticket. Stop playing. Stop talking about it and be about it. And I think we have a couple more photos under Synergy pick 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, they're bad. They're okay. So they're kind of fuzzy. I tried to pull them from your Facebook page, but there were some where you had some really powerful quotes that I love. But I love what you're doing. I want to allow both of you to kind of give your closing remarks because we are just about going to wrap up here.
Sure. So I just want to say, first and foremost, thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
And then as far as, you know, like I said, I do private parties. I do events. And I do private shopping, and you can always find out where I'm going to be. You just go to my website, which is www.curvy. C-U-R-V-Y. Chicks is C-H-I-X. Chariot, C-H-A-R-I-O-T.com. I'm on Instagram. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Twitter. You know, I'm out there. But I really post, you know, wherever I'm going to be. And we also have a group called the DC Fashion Truck Tour. So I'm an organizer for that. And it's a collaboration of various independent business owners who have fashion trucks. We'll go around and do different events. So there's a lot of different ways that, you know, you can really jump on the innovation of this new type of business, doing retail out of a fashion truck. Yeah. So
fantastic. And congrats on your Black Enterprise write-up.
Well, thank you.
That was in Jet. Did you see the Jet?
I didn't see the Jet.
I was in Jet Magazine. Yes.
Congrats.
Where did we find that at?
It's actually the June issue, and I think it may have been the last print.
Okay. Oh, wow.
Because you know they're going all digital.
All digital, yeah.
So I made it into that. So I was excited.
Well, congrats. And the issue for the Black Enterprise is what, the most recent?
It is the Black Enterprise. It's on their blackenterprise.com.
Okay, blackenterprise.com.
It is.
Check her out. She has a whole write-up on Curvy Chicks Chariot. Yeah, congrats on all your success. I'm so proud of you.
Our 1-year anniversary is in September. So
awesome.
We'll be in business for 1 year.
Oh, that is fantastic. I'm going to call you to come drive up to my house and park. I want the full experience. I don't want nobody on the truck with me. And Nisha, you want to give us your closing remark?
I do. I want to encourage people to come out on Sunday. You know, I think it's going to be it's going to be an amazing event.
It is.
But if you are not able to, we're going to have some extraordinary women. My big thing is access. I want us to have access to women who are at the top of their game. Mm-hmm. And so we have some incredible lineups coming. And also, if you go to Synergy Life 2014, we'll continue to have updates there. So I want you to check that out. And I think that, you know, the last thing I want to say for people is about Synergy is that we have to be good so that others can be good. Mm-hmm. We become so that others can. And so in keeping with the Synergy philosophy, if, you know, get good so that we could be better.
I love it. Thank you so much, ladies, for joining me today. I appreciate the conversation. It's been dynamic. I love this setting because it's comfortable. It's easy. It's like we're sitting around the kitchen table. So I'm like, yeah, girl, that's what I like. I like for people to come into this comfortable environment. And to kind of conclude on what Nisha said, you know, Maya Angelou, I love her. She has a quote and she says, when you learn, teach. Yes. And when you get, give.
That's right.
And that's what both of you are doing. You're teaching, you're giving, you're spreading yourself and your gifts and your talents to impact the world. And we need you. We appreciate you. We value you. And I'm going to have y'all come on the show again so we can have a whole another hour conversation. But until next time, thank you folks for tuning in. Be sure to check both these ladies out on the web. And make sure you join us back here again next Tuesday, 2 p.m. Eastern Time on Playtime Is Over Radio. We'll talk to you then. It might seem